Your teacher has asked you to get your science project done. And in a hurry, you did it carelessly. Eventually, you messed up the whole science project. So what did you do? You botched up the science project. Yes, botch. The 39th word of the day. Botch. That means to do a task badly or carelessly. Messing up something is called botch. Botch can be used as a noun, as a verb, as well as an adjective. The synonyms of botch are make a mess, mismanage, or mishandle. Now let's observe botch as a noun or naming word. Don't tell him to do, else he will make a botch of things. Make a botch of things means he will mess up everything. So better don't tell him to do anything. In this sentence, botch is used as a noun. To make a botch of things means when you do something carelessly or you mess up something. We say to make a botch of things. Now let's observe it as a verb. I botched the lines of my school play as I stammered a lot out of nervousness. I botched the lines. That means I messed up the lines of my school play. You will botch the recipe if you don't stir the spices well. That means you will spoil the recipe if you don't stir it well. Let's observe different forms as a verb. The base form, botch. The S or ES form, botches. The present participle or ing form, botching. The past and past participle form, botched. As an adjective, the word is botched. Botched is an adjective. When a work is done carelessly, we describe it by the word botched. The task itself becomes botched task. It was a botched attempt of baking a cake. That means it was an attempt that miserably failed of baking a cake. Now I have a sentence for all of you, and you have to guess whether the word botch is used as a noun, as a verb, or as an adjective. And the sentence is, I would botch my attempt of dieting every time I attend a party. I would botch my attempt of dieting. I would botch. I would botch. After would, we always use a verb. So here the word botch is used as a verb. So here with this, we come to the end of the video, and you have again got a new word with you. Now quickly frame a sentence and write it below. I'll be again back with a new word. And yes, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Bye-bye. Take care.